With technology advancing every day, people still feel the need to have an emulator with them. Because let's be honest, not everyone has high-end PC or high-end smartphone. With this in mind, I have found one of the best Android emulators for a PC, having RAM as low as 512 MB. This emulator can support even 256 MB of RAM. Hey everyone, welcome to Nepags. I am Saurabh. And in this tutorial, I'm going to show you one of the best Android emulators for low-end PCs. This emulator supports any amount of RAM. I mean, you can go as low as you want and as high as your PC supports. Let's download the emulator first. I have found the official download link after a long research. However, it seems to work rarely. I'll put the link in the description for you. But I have to download this emulator with a third-party download link, so I'll put that link as well. I'm pretty sure that the official one has a big issue in their website. After you downloaded the emulator, open to install it. The loading process is really slow, so don't worry, this happens in every PC. First, you have to select the language. I will click OK because the English is already selected. Now, choose I accept the agreement and the next option will unlock. Then click on next. Now, if you want to install the KO player into the default location, click next. And if you want to install it on a custom location because of storage and performance issue, follow me. Click on browse. Select the drive you want to install on. Then navigate to a specific folder and click OK. Now, click next. As soon as you click the next button, the installation process begins. This process will take some time depending on your specs. This KO player is one of the best amongst Android emulators for low-end gamers. I have also played Free Fire and PUBG with this emulator on a 2GB RAM PC. You can easily play the game at lowest settings, but there is no guarantee for the best experience. As a gamer, you have to know that all the components including your CPU, graphics, hard disk or SSD and RAM affects your performance. If you have one of the components at minimum, the other components will complement them for the higher performance. So, this is the one for you. Install it and run it. Once the installation is complete, you will be given an option to choose the rendering mode. I think the default speed mode is best. Now tick this checkbox if you want to save the speed mode for rendering and click on this button. As soon as you click the continue button, the emulator begins to load the files. You can track progress on the progress bar in terms of percentage. The progress bar moves very slowly on all devices. Maybe the emulator only uses a specific amount of your computer resources in order to keep it cool. I have tried this step in both low-end laptop and high-end laptop. Obviously, the high-end has a faster completion rate than the low-end. However, the time consumed during this progress is longer than usual in both laptops. And that's nothing in comparison to the feature this emulator offers. I was not so hopeful at this stage. And one more thing, if your launcher is stuck on 99%, don't worry. It will get the job done. You only have to wait a bit longer at 99%. Once the KO player opens, you will see a beginner guide. You can view the guide by clicking the next button or you can skip it from the top left corner as well. Once you get out of the beginner guide, you will directly be prompted to the login screen. You can choose to log in to your Google account. Once you log in successfully, this beautiful home screen appears. I was thinking of some older kind of home screen, but the beauty of this screen amazed me. Now let's see the features this emulator offers. All of the features are available on the left-hand side of the emulator. Being a really low-spec emulator, it really offers a lot from my point of view. The first one that looks like a keyboard is actually a keyboard settings, from where you can set a custom gamepad. The second option is the shake feature. This icon is to rotate the screen for the apps that really need different orientation while running. this seizure will take and save the screenshot of the emulator's display. The shared folder option will let you choose the custom path once you click it. This is a webcam option. The GPS is also useful sometimes. And the video recording feature is one of the surprising features of this emulator. And finally, the feature to install APK from your PC storage is this. Click this icon and locate the APK to install. And these are volume up, volume down, options and full screen icons. Now let's move towards actual settings available on this emulator. The default resolution is best for most PCs, but you can choose the resolution from here. The most important setting lies in the Advanced tab. From the Advanced tab, you can choose the amount of RAM you want to allocate for this emulator. The default is 1024 MB, which equals to 1 GB. The rendering mode is based at speed, which uses DirectX for rendering. You can always change this renderer in order to boost speed because of compatibility of CPU for DirectX and OpenGL. Some CPUs and graphics prefer DirectX and some prefer OpenGL. And it's better to enable virtualization technology to improve the performance. You can change the size of RAM from here. Click on this option and change it to 512 MB to allocate 512 MB of RAM for this emulator. Finally, click on Save and the emulator will ask for Restart. Choose Restart now and wait till the emulator opens up. Now, you can download and install games like Free Fire and PUBG in this emulator and start playing. So, I hope this tutorial has been helpful for you. If you like this tutorial, then subscribe to my channel for more useful videos like this. And this much for today, my friends. See you in the next video.